frogs in the king's oven, frogs in the king's bread, frogs
all over Egypt.
All over.
And the Bible said that Pharaoh told Moses, go tell your God.
Yeah.
I can get the hint now that these things are only happening to us. And God is not bothered with y'all. Go and tell your God.
Yeah,
I'll let him go.
Yeah.
And the Bible said he went back on his word. When God saw that now, everything he tried, Pharaoh's heart was still hard. The scripture said, last man, God said, I know how I can get him out. And you got to know that God could have got him out anyway. But all this was done not only so Pharaoh could believe, but so that Israel would believe. And some of the stuff that God allowed us to go through is so that you and I would believe that there really is a God. It's not designed to break us. It's not designed to depress us. It's not designed to make us walk away from God. But it's designed to draw us closer to God. So when we realize that God is able and that God is real, when we come to the knowledge that God can supply all of our needs, when we come to the knowledge that God can give us life instead of death, then our belief in God is strengthened.
Yeah.
Hear the Bible said that the last plague, God said he was going to send a death angel.
All right.
And kill all of the firstborn that were born to the Egyptians.
Uh-huh.
So he sends out a message to the Israelites, saying, oh Lord, that they should kill the lamb.
Yeah.
And sprinkle the blood on the doorpost.
Yeah.
And the scripture says, he said, when I see the blood, I'll pass over that house.
Yeah.
And you got to know that because that it was conditional, I'm pretty certain that there were some Israelites that either did not believe or was not willing to kill a lamb or that did not sprinkle the blood on their doorpost. And whatever God says is going to come to pass. And if God says, and sprinkle the blood on the doorpost. And when I see the blood, I pass over your house. To me, that's simple enough. That's straightforward enough. And I believe God enough to know that God will do what he said.
Yeah.
The Bible says that there did not the death angel rode. And he went in and killed all the firstborn of Egypt.
Yeah.
And Pharaoh cried and said, it's enough.
All right.
Oh, Lord, tell Moses to get these people and get on out of Egypt.
Yeah.
And the Bible said that God delivered them with a mighty hand. And even when they thought that they had gotten all the way out, the Bible said they found themselves at the bank of the Red Sea.
Yeah.
And there, Pharaoh's army was in high pursuit. And you got to know that Pharaoh and his army, as Mama said, had held them. And they wasn't about no plan, but they were coming to try to do some damage. But I like what Joseph told his brothers. You meant it for bad, but God meant it for good. When they got there in hot pursuit, and Israel saw that they couldn't go nowhere, oh Lord, they began to complain and cry out to Moses. And the Bible said that God opened the Red Sea and allowed them to walk across on dry land. And God was so good, the scripture said that when the Egyptians tried to walk on the same dry land, oh Lord, that God caused the sea to come back to its place. And Pharaoh's whole army was drowned.
Yeah.
Now God have led them in the wilderness.
Yeah.
And God have promised them to give them a land that flow with milk and honey. God have promised to take them to a place place, the land where they have a home that they didn't have to build. He's gonna take them to a place that had trees that they didn't have to plant. He was gonna take them to a place that had wells that they did not have to dig. And all they had to do was believe and trust in God. God did not tell them that they were gonna have to fight for the land, but he simply said, I'm gonna give it to you. And on the way to that land, while they were marching in the wilderness, the Bible said, that God continued to show Israel that he had all power. He continued to show them with signs and wonders. You know, sometimes when there are no street lights, you got to know that there was no gunpowder and there were no street lights. But God led them, the scripture said, in the daytime by a couple of clouds. Whenever the cloud moved, then the Israelites would move. When the cloud stood still, then they did would stand still. Then at nighttime, he led them with a pillar of fire. Fire in the cloud. And when they saw the fire move, that was their signal to move. So when I say God led them, God really did lead them. Now they're almost at the promised land.
All right,
Jesus. And that they might know to trust in the Lord.
Yes.
There were times when there was no drinking water.
Uh-huh.
And they called on God, and he caused water to come out of a standing rock. There were times when there was no food to eat. And God rained down quail from heaven. And he rained down manna from heaven. There were times when they got weary. And God gave them a place to lay their weary head. They marched for 40 years. And God said, these 40 years have I marched. Trying to prove whether you believe and obey me or not. Now, as God is ready to lead them into the promised land, and can I just tell you, the scripture said that God told them, I want you to go and make sure that this land really is what I said it is. Moses, I want you to get your 12 spies. Send them over into the land and see if it's a good land. And the Bible said that when they got there, they began to search out the land. And in this land, it was just as God described it. In this land, the scripture said, they picked the cloth of grapes and two men had to carry them because of how big they were. In this land, the cities and the walls were fortified. In this land, the cattle was good and healthy, and it was plenty. But instead of looking at the goodness in the land, the Bible said they started looking at the people who were already in the land. And I like the song they sang that said, what God has for me, it is for me. I don't care who's holding it right now. When God get ready for me to have it, I know that God has a way to have me to have it. The scripture says that when they went into the land, that there they saw the Amalekites and the sons of Anak, which looked like giants. And the Bible said, they said in their own eyesight, they looked like little bitty grasshoppers. And